pesar de mí. Dime por qué, qué fue lo que me viste. Si lo que hago es herirte y aún me amas así. Tu amor va más allá de mis defectos. Tu amor es tan sincero, tan perfecto. Es que tu amor va más allá de lo que veo. En una sonrisa, en un simple abrazo o en un tierno beso. Es que tu amor va más allá de lo que siento. Por un nuevo día, por darme la vida y tantos momentos. Tu amor es tan perfecto. Simplemente perfecto. Dime por qué, a pesar de mis errores, vas borrando mis temores que me impiden llegar a ti. Dime por qué.
Steward.
And yo,
soy J. Jesús Rodríguez Caballero. Este es tu show. Listen to me, que comienza ahora.
Bueno, mi gente, es otro martes más bendecido. Está medio tormentoso el día, está como bueno para sopa. Pero este es Listen to Me. Yo soy su anfitrión, JJ Rodríguez, con Mimi Steward, Paloma Martinez, and my good friend over here, Brett, right? Brett Schulman. Okay, even if they see us, but what the hell? But Brett, we're gonna be talking to you about a new organization, and actually, Randy Ross was one of the guys that gave us the first news of what this organization is about. But we're gonna kick it off in a little while. But we want to just jump right into the music because it's a Tuesday and it's really mellow and it's kind of rainy. So we're going to give something nice, Christian, soft to lift the spirits in such a beautiful day and gift of God. And listen to me. We'll be right back.
Yeah, give me 2 seconds. There you go.
And now?
Okay.
Algo tan simple no puedo captar, mi mente no puede captar, de oro oscuro no puedo caminar, y sin a veces tropezar, y a veces me dan ganas de dejarlo todo, seguir mi camino, pero de algún modo, tu presencia me hace a mí suspirar, un toque inmortal a mortal, levantas empiezo yo a respirar, mi corazón a palpitar, y te hago una pregunta, aunque no quiero cuestionarte. Por favor, dime, ¿qué de ti puede separarme?
Tú y yo, juntos hasta el fin del mundo y más allá.
Nadie te separa de mi amor.
Nada, nada. Tú y yo, juntos hasta el fin del mundo y más allá.
Nadie te separa de mi amor.
Nada. No sé por qué te importan las cosas que has hecho. No soy como tú, yo las desecho. Muy profundo en el mal, donde nadie la puede encontrar. Para ti tengo amor incondicional, esto nadie lo va a parar. Tú y yo, juntos hasta el fin del mundo y más allá.
Nadie te separa de mi amor.
Puedo creerlo, el amor que por mí tienes, dice no es para tú comprenderlo, es para que vivas siempre aquí, en mis brazos, libre de rechazos, y te dejes llevar por mis pasos. La pena sé que son grandes, y yo puedo entender que la vida se pone a veces fría, y no es de más cruel.
Por eso toma hoy mi mano, sigue mi camino, levanta tu cabeza, la cuerda que somos. Tú y yo, juntos hasta el fin del mundo y más allá.
Nadie te separa de mi amor.
Nada, nada. Tú y yo, juntos hasta el fin del mundo y más allá.
Nadie te separa de mi amor.
Alto, ni lo profundo, ni ninguna otra cosa creada nos pueda separar del amor de Dios. Solo está en nosotros poder vivir en ese amor y entender que lo pasado es pasado. Alberto Milagro, Visión, Power Rock, Auxi Alumni, Cadillac, Auxiliary, La Machina Melódica, Solange, sube tus estándares musicales y escucha Ocean Alumni.
Bueno, mi gente, será. Listen to me. Aquí estamos en el programa número uno, the best in the world in English and in Spanish, broadcasting from cyberspace desde Central Florida. Bueno, había un día medio tormentoso, so un poquito de música para relajar el alma. But we were already here with my brother, Brett Schulman. And Brett, you're the treasurer of the Orange County Trump Republican Club. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, first of all, we're really excited to be on your program today. So thank you so much for the invite. This is a brand new club that just got started about a week ago. And it basically consists of several individuals that are coming out and saying that we are going to continue the momentum for President Trump and continue this positive and professional language that needs to be placed into our community. And basically what we do is we're doing outreaches, like, for example, we're being on the radio today, which we appreciate.
Thank you.
A lot of support activities and house events and fundraisers. And basically we're here to take some action. We're not going to sit on the sidelines. We're going to make it happen.
So finally, we're going to start stopping the losing streak here in Orange County and Osceola County and probably do something, right?
Yes.
Change this county from blue to red, because right now we're, like I told my brother Randy Ross and Melissa McGee, my sister Melissa McGee, we're behind enemy lines, man. Everywhere else it's red. Todo el lado es republicano en Florida, menos aquí y en Osceola and Orange County. So let's see what's going on. But brother, you tell off camera, before the show started, you were saying that the membership is growing, que está creciendo la membresía. Tell us a little bit more about that. How what are the efforts that you're doing?
Well, mainly, of course, we're doing social media. And as we all know, that social media today plays a huge part in getting people together. And they can simply go out to our Facebook page and go and submit their individual names, and once we do that, we get in contact and we add them to our database. But we're looking for some absolutely phenomenal people that believe in our cause, that believe that we need to push this motivational Trump train forward and just continue to go all the way down to 2020 and reelect our president once again.
That is good. That is good. Yeah, Randy told me about being the Hispanic Outreach Coordinator, so that's a position that we're going to try and work on as we move forward, and that would be an honor to help include Latinos and get them a little bit more involved in the Orange County politics, and not only from my heritage, because I'm from Puerto Rico, yo soy de Puerto Rico, but a lot of people that come from Colombia, Venezuela, República Dominicana, Panama, Bolivia, that rich cultural heritage, they're very, very vocal in voting. But it is one thing Latin American politics, and it's one thing American politics. It's just a night and day. There's even in my hometown of Puerto Rico, there's differences. There's pro-statehood, pro-commonwealth, pro-independence. Here in the United States, Republican or Democrat. And sometimes you don't even know the difference between one and the other.
Well, I can tell you there's a huge difference.
I know there's a huge difference. Yeah. But again, from coming from a generation that is just coming off, fresh off the boat, like I used to say, or coming from the airport from Puerto Rico, that's their picture, and they come up and
right.
They say, hey, enough of all this politics, and they get burned up.
Yes.
So we got to find another way to re-energize them and activate them into the political process.
Yes.
So you say you have a website. What's the website?
If they'll simply go over to the Facebook page and go to the Orange County Trump Republican Club, they'll find all the information that they need. Go over there and submit your information, and we'll get in touch with you. And we will start having a lot of events. Now, this is just, like I said before, it's brand new. We've only been out for a week, and we are seeing a tremendous amount of different clubs just go crazy all over Central Florida. And now they're everywhere. They're starting to pop up everywhere. So that's very exciting stuff. And, you know, it's like Monopoly. You just keep buying those places, and it gets bigger and bigger and bigger, and that's what it's all about. And we're here to do a lot of great things. We're here to take action. That's the main thing. Not just sit on the sidelines and, you know, watch the train go by. You got to get on the Trump train. Go out there and be active. You know, go to the fundraisers and go to the special events and help each other as Republicans do.
That is good, Brett. And, well, you people know it. Ustedes lo saben. Vayan a la página de Facebook de Orange County Trump Republicans Club, ¿verdad? That's the you can look, search for that, Orange County Trump Republican Club in Facebook. Aquí para Orange County, Osceola County. Puede ser republicano. You're right. You could be a Republican. You could be a Democrat.
It doesn't matter. We'll take doesn't anybody. Matter.
We'll take anybody. Todo el mundo puede aplicar. Y le vamos a enseñar cómo son las riendas del gobierno americano. We're going to teach them about American politics and how to become a better citizen within
it's
the politics.
It's all 100% positive.
Yeah.
It's all doing the same thing, and that's for a better future for all of us.
Good, 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 good. But brother, Brett, you tell me also that you're a 13-time world champion in offshore race, in offshore racing team, like boats or cars? What's the speed?
Yeah. I know it's fast and it's speed, so what is
it? It's fast and it's furious. We have a 42-foot fountain. Uh-huh. We are the 13-time world champion. Matter of fact, we were just on NBC yesterday.
Oh, cool.
And they were showing the show when we won the world championship in Key West in November for the 13th time. And we are very proud of our team. We Peter Meyer and Julie Meyer up in New York. We keep our boat over in Malabar, Florida. And we're going to Bimini, Bahamas. That's right, Bimini, Bahamas. In 3 weeks,
cool.
We're going to be racing in the OP races. But then we're coming back to Cocoa Beach May 19th. 11 p.m., you're going to see Instigator out there defend its world championship and put the smack down on everybody.
All right, a little bit of wrestling talk. Un poquito de habladura de lucha libre. Pero para que las personas entiendan un poquito, Brett, what is the racing? It's boats, right?
Yes, boats? It's offshore racing. There's right. We have
how fast those boats could go?
Our racing boat goes anywhere between 120, 130 miles an hour. It's got twin 850 Scorpions. As I said before, it's a 42-foot fountain that is just absolutely fast and furious.
Wow, wow, wow. So more than 100 miles plus, right?
Oh, definitely.
So the wipeouts are not really wipeouts, right?
We've actually never crashed.
Cool. So
we've
that's
been very, very that's fortunate.
That's very, very good. And how famous versus car racing are these boat races?
Well,
here in Florida, at least.
Well, here's the beautiful thing about anywhere we race. We have a beach.
So that's important.
That's right.
A lot.
It's more of a summer sport, right?
Yes, but also in the colder months, of course. You know, September, October, November. The beautiful thing about that is it's free, and that's where we get 100,000 to 200,000 people out there watching the races along the coast of wherever we are. Mm-hmm. That's the exciting part because, you know, what we're really excited about is NBC coming aboard and being part of that, NBC Sports.
So basically, you could see all the races through NBC Sports then.
That's right. All you could go on YouTube. You could go to Brett TV. You could go to Superboat International on YouTube, and you could TiVo everything. You could see all the races right there and check them out.
And also, you are the driver of the world's largest monster Trump truck featured in Fireball Run. Okay, now I've heard of the Cannonball Run when Menudo was playing, but what is the Fireball Run?
Well, I'm glad you asked.
Ain't I nosy?
No, it's beautiful. Last year, I got the opportunity to do the Fireball Run, which is a TV show / reality show that involves finding missing and exploited children. Mm-hmm. And what we do is we go 8 days and 8 nights with 40 teams that have vehicles from all over the world.
Wow.
And we start in New York and we go 2,500 miles in a adventurally, an epic adventurous race. And you guys can check that out at fireballrun.com. You can see it in September on Amazon Prime. And I'm actually one of the characters. And I had the pleasure of driving the world's largest monster Trump truck.
Wow.
That was sponsored by Aaron Hope, of course, who is our AMH Construction a sponsor, along with Peter and Julie Meyer and Billy Moff and all those other guys. And we took that truck 5,000 miles. And our biggest sponsor, of course, was President-elect Donald J. Trump.
All right, all right. So that's gonna be good. So this is gonna be done in September.
Yes.
Amazon Prime. That's where we could see him.
Yes.
So ustedes pueden ver el Fireball Run, que va a ser una carrera a campo traviesa con diferentes tipos de máquinas. And how are these like altered? There's a type of regulation on the body work, or they're just big 4x4s?
Well, actually, I'm glad you asked.
Again, I'm nosy.
We had everything from a DeLorean.
Okay,
you know, like the Back to the Future car?
Yeah.
Yes.
Really?
We had a DeLorean, we had Lamborghinis, we had Ferraris, Skip Fowler, love that guy. We had one of the most beautiful Rolls Royces you've ever seen that was involved. The McLaren was the winner this year, which was driven by a woman that owns, I forgot her name, by the way, and I apologize, but she owns Cup, you know, the Solo Cup company.
Yep, yep.
So she was absolutely fearless and unbelievable and unstoppable, and she did phenomenal.
So that means that I can drive the Trump monster truck.
We actually sold the Trump truck.
Oh man, I really wanted to drive that. So,
see, I knew Paloma, you're coming to the dark side.
Yeah. I will crash it though, that's for sure.
But it's actually, it was,
I'm a woman driver,
by the way.
That's true. Hey, don't say that about yourself.
Anyway, so yeah, and the most important thing about the Fireball Run is this. The children's, finding the children's missing network. That's the most important thing. We have lost, we have actually found 47 children.
Wow.
47 children out of the funding that we have given away, donated to the actual organization. So this is a very serious program. So along with having a great time, we're finding missing children who have been exploited and just gone off the beaten path. So that's very exciting.
That's something very interesting too, because again, back to what Miss Paloma Martinez wants to do with the changing room, which is to create change from people to people.
Right.
That would be an awesome,
a good niche.
A niche, yes, good niche to talk about. So again, and listen to me, people meet, you know, physically, you know, and they share ideas.
Yep.
So that is what we have to do.
So fireballrun.com, go check it out.
Fireball.com, vayan a ese sitio de internet para ver todo sobre la carrera y cuando se va a ver. And this is going to be in Amazon Prime, right?
Yes, that's in September.
Y si ustedes tienen, para los que son nerds y que les gusta todo lo que es tech y todo eso, pues vayan a fireball.com y en está
fireball
en
fireballrun.com
like y pueden drink. Ir en. Oh, like the drink. For those of you that are over 21 and know what they're talking about. Thank you.
Legal disclosure.
So basically, vayan a ese sitial y pueden ver. Y además, para los que estén suscritos a Amazon Prime in September, ¿verdad?
Yes.
En septiembre pueden ver todas las carreras y qué es lo que están pasando. And basically, y eso es para ayudar a encontrar adolescentes y niños que están desaparecidos o perdidos, or Amber Alerts, right? Basically,
yes.
When there's an Amber Alert,
yes,
you try to help them,
yes,
get those babies back. But vamos a hacer eso.
Oh, can I add one more thing?
Sure.
Last year, we did find one of our children during the season.
What do you mean? So as the race was occurring?
As the race was going on, we got a phone call that one of the children from one of the previous seasons was found.
Wow. So it's not only to help raise money, but it's also to help raise awareness of the kids that are missing, and they could give the tips and call the tip line and
yep.
say, hey, I think I saw this kid walking around here.
And speaking of tips, one of our jobs and responsibilities, because of the 8 days and eight nights, is every single day we go out and we give away those brochures and we post them everywhere we can all over the city where we are located that particular day. So we had 5,000 of those to give away for our child that we represented.
Cool, cool, cool. Well, Brett, stay around a moment. We're gonna keep on talking about all these three things that you've talked about. But I want to go to Mimi. Mimi, how you doing, girl?
Hey, I'm great.
Well, Miss Mimi Steward, we've been kind of preparing for the show, and we have kind of like a bombshell to kind of launch out there. Tenemos un show bien especial y vamos a soltar como una primicia, because esto le está pasando a los niños aquí en Central Florida, in Orange County. y esta es la situación con ellos. And Mimi Stewart is going to tell us a little bit about what's going on. So, Mimi, tell us about what's going on with third graders. Are they getting like post-traumatic stress syndrome or something like that? What's going on?
Yeah, it seems to be a lot of stress going on with 8-year-olds, 9-year-olds starting at third grade.
Mm-hmm.
It has to do with the Florida Standard Assessment. Let me explain, please.
Mm-hmm.
The Florida Standard Assessment is a suite of reading, writing, and math tests designed to measure students' performance. The test is tied to the Florida Common Core Base Standards, which outline what students should know at the end of each grade. The federal government has promoted the Common Core, and that has people concerned, because back in 2013, Florida Republican lawmakers, Governor Rick Scott, objected to the use of two federal-funded tests being designed by multi-state groups. Now, Florida sought new testing firms and eventually chose the American Institute for Research earlier back in 2015, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
So after seeking these proposals for the new test, the Florida Department of Education chose the American Institute for Research. AIR is known for high-profile education research. The nonprofit has expanded its testing businesses. So the AIR testing contracts with 15 states, including the Common Core-based exams in Arizona, Florida, and Utah. Now the issue is, it used to be from 4th to 5th grade, higher to 10th grade.
Mm-hmm.
Now they've lowered it down to 3rd grade. And this is where they're seeing a lot of concerns with parents. They're having a lot of 8-year-olds and 9-year-olds stressing, anxiety.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Test anxiety, depression, and so forth. They've even ended up going to the doctors and they're even having to get some sort of a plan for them in order to help them, I guess you want to say, calm down. Basically, we're putting a lot of pressure on younger kids, and it seems to be getting younger and younger.
So, Mimi, as you say that, I've read some of the news briefs. Basically, this is the state of Florida saying, well, if you don't pass this test, you gotta go, you repeat third grade again.
Pretty much, it is, yeah.
Wow.
This is my concern is, there's not enough information given to parents, not even from the schools. I have an 8-year-old, so I'm facing this year, and this is the first time my son actually came to me crying, saying that he's afraid to fail, and he's afraid that he's going to fail us. And he cried a lot. I've never seen him cry before, at least within mm-hmm. school. Academically, he's in a magnet program, so he's very blessed. He has, you know, he doesn't have a struggle with grades.
Wow.
But it doesn't matter if you pass your report card. You still, if you don't pass this test, you still will get left back.
Well, let me translate a little bit. Bueno, Mimi Stewart nos está trayendo una noticia aquí en Central Florida, el condado de Orange. And this is for Orange County, right? This is Orange County?
It's Florida. Florida.
It's all Florida. Este es para todo el estado de Florida, donde hablan sobre unos exámenes estandarizados. En otras palabras, el estado determina cuáles son los puntos necesarios para pasar un grado. Y lo han bajado hasta el tercer grado. Y esto ha tocado a Mimi Stewart de una forma personal porque ella tiene un hijo que también está con estrés, está tembloroso, se pasa llorando. Y él está en uno de los cursos un poquito más elevado, más avanzado. Pero por ende, todavía este tipo de examen perturba a muchas familias. Y si ustedes saben de otras familias que han sido afectadas por estos exámenes, porque los niños se están afectando, nos gustaría escuchar su historia. Así que comuníquense con radiount.net o a través de BBN Informa en YouTube, BBN Informa y Info en YouTube, y comuníquense ahí donde vamos a poner los programas pasados. But Mimi, you're right. Some of these tests sometimes don't reflect the true knowledge of a child. It's been proven in the past.
It's kind of hard to each his own. Some don't do well in testing alone, and so they do well in quizzes in the classroom. But when it comes to this particular test, it takes a long time with excessive amount of questions. That's when they get nervous, and that's when we have a problem with that. So yet they can pass their test or quizzes or report card, but you can't pass unless you pass this test.
Well, it's kind of strange because while I was looking at the information on these assessments, most of the news comes from last year, 2016.
Yeah.
2017, we haven't found anything new.
This is why I'm speaking about it.
So basically, it's good that we're doing this, right. And probably we could that would be a piece of information where we both could put our energies of the team to try and figure out. Probably the Republican Club could help us find some school board members that could speak with us and talk to us about this again. We've invited congressmen, but, you know, Congressman Val Demings, Stephanie Murphy, Darren Soto.
Well, see, this is why I would like to keep this as a hot topic. There's a lot of questions a lot of us have. Like, for instance, how many times can you take this test? Mm-hmm. It's not really given no information unless you have to do your research on computer, which is hard to find. Because sometimes it's every year. How many times do they get per year, though, a chance to pass this test?
One shot.
And then, so after that, what happens? Is there a summer school? Is there any sort of other option?
No, because they don't even know that. They don't even know the result towards the end of the year, so they don't even know what they're gonna tell you, you know.
So they just tell you what you passed or you didn't pass.
Well, you get the grades at the end of the year. You might think that you passed, but later on in the summer, they might come back at you and say, "Hey, he didn't pass the SAT or whatever it's called now."
Right. It's
FSA. Yeah.
FSA.
FSA. He didn't pass it, so he's gonna have to go back. So it's actually during the summertime when to mess up people's summer.
So the stress level is actually
higher. You get your results before summer school. But
after summer school is done.
After summer school is done. Mm-hmm. Okay, now there's no other option. There's no exception.
No,
from what
because
I've
it's
heard.
Actually it's not even a grade. It doesn't affect your grades. Your grades are your grades. So you got A and B's. You got A and B's. But if you don't pass this, you don't pass your whatever grade you're in.
So basically,
so you're taking third, fourth, right. Fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10th, 11th, 12th.
Well, the past, if I'm not mistaken, the past 4 years it went down to fourth and fifth. It went down to third. So are we going to keep going down? I already see the third graders really facing a hard issue because third grade comes in as they're independent. They're learning to be independent. They're learning to work on their own. So yet they have this on top of that. It's too much.
You know, I don't.
You
I
know
don't
what? Be, my, Jay, sorry about that.
No
you know
what's
my issue? Because I went through this last year, I believe, with my son. And you know what's my issue with that test is?
What?
It's not like they give a test to my son because I know, like she said about her son, he's capable of doing it and getting it right. My issue is that they're not preparing the kids to take the test. You know what I'm saying?
Here's the test and voila.
Yeah, because so you're telling me that preparing the kids to take that test, so you're not preparing to take the courses, the classes, because you cannot prepare a kid to do two different things.
Yeah.
The test is a whole different topic than the classes that they're taking in school.
So the curriculum, is one thing, and the test is another.
Yeah.
You could have.
So no. So they might help them. The curriculum might help them to take the test, but that is not going to teach them nothing in the classroom.
That's true.
Because it's teaching them how to pass the test.
Yeah.
But it's not teaching them how to pass a class or learn whatever they got to learn during in the daily basis.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah.
So you pick your choice. You know what I'm saying? What you're gonna be teaching these kids?
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you ask the teachers, because I went last year to the school and I asked the teacher. To be honest, like Mimi said earlier, it's nothing. I'm not talking bad about teachers. They do.
No.
But some of them don't know.
Yep.
Right. Some of them want to talk about. Some of them really don't know anything of anything. Oh, that's the curriculum. I just got to do what they give me.
That's it.
And that's...
So then we have to ask that...
There's no information.
So what we've learned is that there's an iceberg, and as we know with icebergs, the tip may be popping out of the water, but the iceberg could be pretty big below the water. So what lurks below the surface is what we have to start tapping into. And I think that that's a very commendable thing. And I think for the next couple of weeks, we should kind of knock that down.
Yes.
I will make an effort to try and speak to school board members and members of the Florida government and the Orange County government to see if we could get some guests to talk about that. Because the thing of it is one thing you learn in the classroom. The other thing is that here, have a test and let's see if you pass. I know I could see where that stress could come from, and I see that, and I see it in your eyes because you love your kids, and as a mother, you don't like to see them in that position. But is there anything that the state can do to alleviate that stress? Because
I got to ask you something, Jay. Sorry about me.
Uh huh.
You know it's funny.
Tell me.
I brought this up to the teacher last year.
Mm-hmm.
School is with that nonsense of bullying. No bullying in school, right?
Yep.
But that's technically what they're doing to the kids.
They're bullying them.
That is right. That is right.
That's technically what they're doing to the kids.
Yeah. If you look at the pure definition of bullying, that's it.
They're
stressing the kids out.
They're
putting pressure on the kid.
Too much.
So what's the difference between a kid making fun of your son? Because when I was in school, and I'm pretty sure when you all of y'all were in school, people used to make fun of all of us. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we used to make fun of people at the same time.
Yeah, we all got
And that back then wasn't bullying. But a teacher putting pressure, or a school system putting pressure on a kid in that level, No, that's bullying.
Yeah,
but not to them.
Yeah, well, yeah, because it's in the eye of the beholder. Es el que ve la acción, pues determina. Ay, yo no estoy haciendo nada malo. Sí, estás haciendo algo malo. Estás poniendo presión a un nene que se supone que no le pongas presión. You should be teaching this child, opening his mind to be a new doctor, a scientist, a politician, whatever that person wants to be. Not, hey, by the way, if you don't pass this test, you gotta repeat. And they give you the added stress that they don't even tell you if you pass or fail.
They don't until after the fact. But then, yet everyone has to be on computers now. Where's the hands-on? You know, like the kids are kind of losing their mind at a way too young age. They don't even like school at this point now. It's too much. When you start to see eight-year-olds stress and come home crying, it is not just my own. Mm-hmm. I've seen it.
It's just so much pressure. They don't even realize it. Let's go and say that your son want to play basketball in school. Now he has to, after school, he got to go to practice. The practice is extensive. It's like 3 hours. Mm-hmm. They don't play around. Right?
Yeah. Here in Florida, last
so little. School is done at what? Two? Mm-hmm. Three? Mm-hmm. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So he got 3 hours of practice. That's 6, 7. Then he got to go home and do what? Study?
His homework.
And do homework and all that. So he get done at what? 10 p.m.?
Oh, yeah. About
Let's
that.
Go and say 10 p.m., yeah. right?
Yep.
So then he got to go to bed and wake up at what? 5 a.m. because he got to be by the bus stop at 6?
Yep. Yeah,
they can't take anything home. When they go home, it has to be homework and that's that. So they can't be a kid. It's way too young to be putting this much pressure on a young kid that should be having their freedom.
They're trying to get this kid, or you should join the science club or the math club or the basketball team or the baseball team. But they don't tell them all the pressure that they actually put on this kid. Because there is a whole lot of pressure. Whenever they got basketball games, whenever they get to middle school or high school, now they got to travel, they got to go away. Then they go home at 9 or 10 p.m. because the basketball game starts at 7.
Yeah.
They get done at 10 or 11. Then what about homework? Yep. But if you don't keep your GPA of 2.5, you can't play.
You're out.
Well, how am I supposed to keep my GPA at 2.5 if I can't even be home by 9?
Yeah.
I think corporate world has damaged the education system, and we have to look at the education system as what it is, to enlighten brains and to make sure that children are prepared to be better citizens in the tomorrow. Not like Mimi's been saying, like they're stressed out and they don't even enjoy their youth. No se disfrutan la juventud.
Because they're looking at the money side of it. Everything that brings money to the school system, that's what they want to do. All this stuff, that test, all that, that's money. Because the more kids that pass that test, the more money the school will get. Then they will become an A grade school or B grade school, and that's when they start getting more money. Whenever the basketball team or the school is good, they start getting more money. Whenever the volleyball team is good, they get more money. That's all they care. It's about the money. Don't care the kid pass or not. They really don't.
Well, this is why I wanted to bring it out. I just didn't understand why I wasn't getting any information from the teachers, nor the principal at a point. I had to kind of fight my way through. Thank God I'm blessed with, you know, good administrative team.
Good.
You know, that has helped me out because of me fighting to get more information. But I wanted to really release this, and hopefully everyone out there that's listening, you know, please voice your opinion.
Yeah,
we gotta stick together. It's your voice is not small. Like, we can stick together, or we can make this large enough to be heard, to get our questions answered, to understand the critique of it, to really get down to the bottom of it with information that you guys really don't know. Because there's a lot of detailed information in here that we might be overlooking, or there might be an option we might not know about.
Last year, I was watching the news, and a girl, a third grader, this whole thing went to court because of this. A third grader, I think she went to stress or something, and the mom went to court, and it was big because of the same thing.
I saw the reports from Tampa. It was somewhere in Tampa that the reports were coming. But the thing is that I want to try and talk and see what we could talk about in Orange County, because since this show is originating from Orange County out to the world and cyber world, it would be good to be able to see if we could get some school board officials, see what they could to say about. And even if the Florida Education Department, we should talk to that. And hey, you know, Betsy DeVos is a friend. Her last name, even she's the cabinet appointee for Trump. She's in charge of the Department of Education. It would be even great if anybody of those departments can come to our show or even call us and say, hey, well, this is what's going on. This is what's going on. Because, again, it's like Miguel Montes has said, this is a business, but is the business really benefiting the children or benefiting somebody else? Do we have to follow the money trail? What's the money trail going to lead us? So yes, this show started asking us asking a lot of questions, but we're going to start searching for the answer. And real good.
Yeah.
Thank you. Mimi Stewart on the line there, getting the news here and listen to me. Yes, sir. Well, anyway, we have Brett still here. We have been bothering him. He's been taking some selfies and stuff like that, chit-chatting with us. But we're going to bug him a little bit more in a little while. We're going to go to another song. And then when we come back from Listen to Me, we'll talk to Brett about the Orange Republican, Trump Republican Club again, and his
offshore. He's a captain. I wonder if he's seen Captain Jack Sparrow out there in the races. But let's go to the thing.
Anyway, listen to me. Listen to me. Bueno, mi gente, aquí estamos en Listen to Me, la edición del martes pomposo, poderoso, entusiasmado, enchulado de la vida que tenemos aquí, gracias a Dios. Porque sin Dios, nada se puede. Y con un día tan bello, medio así, lluvioso, está como para una sopa, un sopón, unos tostones, tostones de panapén, ya tú sabes. ¿Te está dando hambre, Paloma?
No, me está dando sueño.
¡Ea, rayo! Bueno, but anyway, here we are with Brett. And Brett, brother, just to recap about the, you're the treasurer of the Orange County Trump Republican Club. And again, that's the Facebook page, Orange County Trump Republican Club. So right now, after the first meeting, is there any other activities events or anything that's planned or on the way to go?
Well, as we speak, we're actually working on different things that we're doing. We're doing outreach programs. We're going to be doing some social activities, house events. We got barbecues coming up. We're going to be taking a lot of action in Orange County. We have a lot of fundraisers that's going to be going on. And so we're going to be doing various things to support our president for 2020, baby.
All right. So you say that there's a barbecue. So that's the May event or by any chance?
Yes.
Or, yeah. That's the one Melissa's going to spear
yes,
up.
Yes, that is correct.
All right.
Melissa
so
McGee.
We got to get her back here in the show. Tell me where are the digits. What's the 411? ¿Dónde está la, pa la comida? I know a lot of people from the Latin descent will go because you offer them food and they go yeah. over. Yeah. They go over there. Yeah, voy para allá.
Hey, Melissa, there's 10,000 people here.
Melissa McGee's, okay, no problem.
We got you. No, great job by Randy Ross and Melissa and Carolyn Cook and Leland McKee, who's the policy analyst, by the way. Cool. So he's doing a great job, too. We love everybody on the team is absolutely wonderful. But we've added a bunch of folks, and we need more. Democrats, Republicans, everybody in Central Florida, come on down.
All right. And if you want to call into the show, it's 407-601-5087. 407-601-5087 if you want to call on the show. Yes, listen to me. To all the friends of Paloma, Martinez, mira como estamos, mijo.
Saludito, mi gente.
So basically, yeah, and one of the things that this is an old piece of news. In Puerto Rico, now they're starting to train youth on shooting techniques in gun ranges in Puerto Rico. You're an instructor?
I actually teach also.
Oh, cool. All
I'm
right.
a former Orange County Deputy Sheriff.
All right.
I didn't do it. I never had that. They told me this was water.
I checked it. It's okay.
All right. So, yeah. So, and yes, as a Republican and Latino, I always like the Second Amendment. But, yeah, I always keep this article over here because things are changing so fast in Puerto Rico that now, after so many years, they're starting to teach minors how to operate safely a handgun.
Which is very important.
And again, it's one of the most things. And before I go on to Paloma, and I have my small little Spanish monologue, otra vez, me van a escuchar. La gente de Puerto Rico, ustedes tienen que entender que en junio 11 es un día muy importante. Va a cambiar la historia. Vamos a cambiar la historia de los Estados Unidos. We're going to change the history of the United States. In June 11th, you have to make a choice between una falsedades que se llama el Estado Soberano o la independencia que perdió su franquicia o la estadidad que nos va a dar pleno representación en el Congreso por primera vez en el Senado en 150 años. So voten estadidad. Nadie sabe, todo el mundo sabe que yo no me escondo sobre nada. Soy estadista para Puerto Rico, pero también abogo para todo latinoamericano. Y Puerto Rico, siendo un estado latinoamericano en el estado de los Estados Unidos de América, puede abrir muchos puentes. Y ustedes van a ver. Voten estadidad. Well, Brett, basically what I was saying is that in Puerto Rico, June 11th, there's a plebiscite. Non-binding, but still they use the money that Obama kind of left us so we could do this because we're broke down there in Puerto Rico. So on June 11th, we're going to do a plebiscite.
Okay.
Statehood versus independence and something called a free associated state, which is something that Guam or some other place is doing. The territorial is not working. It's time to help Puerto Ricans understand that there's a very important choice. It's not a time to stay aside or ignore the political facts.
Right.
We either become part of the United States as the United States, as a sovereign state,
of course,
and have representation in Congress, or we may just disappear as a culture. We may become like the Vulcans.
Live long and prosper, but we're no more.
That's not good.
And especially with 150 years of culture between the United States and Puerto Rico.
Yeah.
Look at the baseball classic.
Yeah.
United States and Puerto Rico for the finals. I was so happy. I was like, yes. So, you know, I would have liked Puerto Rico to win, but
yeah, they did.
And it's a beautiful country. You know, I've seen many pictures of Puerto Rico.
They didn't even show up.
Yeah, you know, so, and they even had a parade. They came in second. They even had a parade down there. That's how we are. We understand as a culture, that we could give the United States so much more. And I know that the United States for many years already has had, we've had a lot of allies. But there's a lot of propaganda from the left.
Right.
That is saying that we will lose our culture, that we will lose our language, we will lose even our sports. We have to be very vigilant to the lies.
Sure.
Like what's going on with education that Mimi has brought up. Mm-hmm. This is something that I've been battling for many, many years. I've been stabbed, I've been shot, my tires have been sliced.
Wow.
That is true political activism, you know. Lou Oliver talks about people burning souls in this. I have burned shoes over shoes over right. shoes over sneakers over Nikes over British Knights.
Everything.
But I've burnt everything. And not only in Orange County, Osceola County, Seminole County, Cook County, Winnebago County, Bexar County, Texas. I've mentioned counties in Texas and in Illinois. Mm. But what we have to do is we have to educate more the Hispanic community
right.
on clubs like you and clubs like ours, which yes. is the Hispanic Republican organization.
Yep.
And we got to keep on doing more.
Yep.
But anyway,
we need to come
since
together.
Paloma is nice and silent over there because she's kind of like, she don't like politics, but I'm getting her into it. She shoots once in a while,
sure.
But Paloma, how you doing, mi corazón? ¿Cómo está todo?
Ay, estoy bendecida, gracias
al Señor. Eso es bueno, eso es bueno, eso es bueno. Pues una de las cosas que queríamos hablar es que the changing room está cambiando.
Está creciendo.
Y estamos cambiando vidas.
Estamos cambiando vidas.
So danos un reportito del changing room y qué vidas hemos cambiado. Who we have changed in the changing room?
Well, el cuarto de cambios, the changing rooms, está ya tomando ventaja en la comunidad. Estamos ya haciendo lo que se supone que estemos haciendo, que es ayudando a Los Ángeles como ustedes a poder proveer la ayuda necesaria en la comunidad. Estamos creciendo tanto que ya estamos en proceso de buscar otra localización para entonces tener un poquito más espacio y poder procesar más las donaciones que estamos recibiendo para entonces poderlas distribuir a todos ustedes que con tanto amor están aportando su tiempo para ayudar a la comunidad. Tengo algo muy interesante, Jay.
Ah, ¿nos vas a decir lo
Ay,
que pasó?
Sí, está. Recientemente, la semana pasada, hicimos un evento Ajá. en un orfanatorio que Ajá. se llama The Carpenter House Ajá. en Leesburg. Ese evento fue algo muy bonito. Ahí hay 14 niños, muchos de ellos tienen problemas como Down Syndrome, autismo. Y ellos siempre se quedan ahí. Ellos no son dados a adopción. O sea que...
Básicamente, ellos salen de ahí a ser
al
adultos.
Mundo, al mundo, ¿no? Sí. Okay. Y Pat y Linda, dos ángeles preciosos que están haciendo una labor increíble en la comunidad, se han dedicado a estos niños. Pero yo entiendo cómo es dar tanto de ti, uh-huh. pero... tenemos que también apoyar a estas personas que están haciendo tan buena labor. Y la forma en que yo pensé que Changing Room podría apoyar a esta tan linda pareja en hacer la diferencia en la vida de estos niños es haciéndole un cumpleaños. Un cumpleaños a cada uno de ellos, pero una tremenda fiesta. Estamos hablando de decoración, payaso, música, cantantes, de todo un poco. O sea, quiero que esto sea algo grandísimo, algo bien bueno. Y... Quiero dejarles saber que ya estamos en proceso, pero necesitamos apoyo. Ahora mismo tengo que darle las gracias al colaborador de Sun, Moon and Star Decorations, que ellos van a estar a cargo de la decoración. También quiero darte las gracias a TJ, porque como siempre,
Thank you.
Siempre estás apoyando el Cuarto de Cambios en todas las actividades que hacemos. También quiero darle las gracias a Mimi Stewart, que también ella está siempre apoyando.
Whoa,
pero
whoa, yeah.
Todavía necesitamos comida. O sea, necesitamos caterers que nos ofrezcan la comida para ese evento. Quiero que sea algo grande, algo bonito. También estoy buscando a alguien que pueda donar cuartos de varios cuartos de un hotel en una playa para entonces mandarlos también a una vacacioncita frente de la playa, porque necesitan pues ese descansito. O sea, una vida a la vez. Eso es lo más importante, tocar una vida a la vez. Pero que si lo hacemos, lo vamos a hacer con bombo y platinos.
Eso es así, es bien importante. Sí, yo puedo servir de DJ, hablamos de eso y toco música para ellos, para que...
Ah, eso era. Yo pensaba que te ibas a poner un tutu y vas a bailarle así como estilo
Bueno, si tú te pones a bailar conmigo la canción del pollito, pues
pollito. Pío. Después que hagamos la diferencia, eso es lo más importante.
Eso sí, me va a dar el placer poder tocar música con ellos y vamos a bregar con eso y a ver si sacamos unos videitos y unas cositas para cuando vengamos acá, pues los podemos enseñar. Y los podemos decir al público. Pero ¿dónde es que queda la casa? ¿Cómo es que se llama la casa otra vez?
Carpenter House Orphanage en Leesburg.
En Leesburg, ok.
Estoy recolectando apoyo financiero para hacer cambio a una localización más grande. Poner a changing rooms en una localización más grande. So, si quieren aportar a la organización, por favor comuníquense conmigo al 321-278-5223. Su aportación será sumamente agradecida.
Gracias.
Paloma, for the orphanage, how old? What are the ages?
They vary from early 8 to 14, 18 actually. They're older kids also.
So 8 years old and older?
From 8 to 18. Okay.
Cool. Pues ya lo saben que vamos a hacer unas actividades y también podemos hacer unas actividades profundo para ellos también.
Acuérdense también, pueden añadir su número de teléfono en la página mía de Facebook para conectarlos al Angels Call Out. Si quieren participar en los eventos que tenemos ahora mismo apoyando, por favor, mándeme su nombre, número de teléfono y cuál es el outreach que más le gustaría participar. Ahora mismo tenemos un evento que les vamos a dar de comer a los homeless por medio de Mouths of Help Through Christ. El señor Gus Martinez está a cargo de ese evento y va a ser ahora en el sábado 8, este sábado de 12 a 4. Todavía necesitamos un par de cositas. Si están dispuestos a aportar su tiempo y ser voluntarios de este gran evento, por favor comuníquense conmigo o con el señor Gus Martinez con Miles of Help Through Christ.
Eso está bueno, pues entonces ya saben, vamos a hacer de esta actividad bien chévere y también nos queda, acuérdense la gente que tenemos Bohemia junio 2, que eso es otra actividad que vamos a tener de comedia y música para toda la familia. Vamos a estar dándole más información, va a ser en el café Mineiro Brazilian Steakhouse el viernes 2 de junio, así que vayan separando la fecha porque eso va a estar lleno de magia. Vamos a tener baile, canto, vamos a tener comedia para toda la familia. Imagínate, el Café Mineiro, Brazilian Steakhouse, eso es una delicia de comida. Bueno, estás saboreándote el rainforest ahí.
Qué rico, yo con hambre.
Pues, estamos hablando de tostones de panapén.
Sí, pero si me vas a poner a trabajar esa noche, más te vale que me des de comer.
Ah, bueno, sí, yo te voy a traer unos granola bars y una botellita
de
agua.
¿En serio?
Seguro, porque es que tú me dijiste que tú estabas a dieta.
Bueno, te vas a salvar bastante dinero porque soy vegetariana.
Pues por eso mismo te traje unas barritas que son de vegetales.
Ok, o hielo en un plato, ¿no?
¿Hielo en un plato?
Sí, eso es lo que me decían cuando yo era vegan.
Ajá.
Sí, que yo comía hielo y aire.
Ajá.
Pero eso no era
verdad. Es que el hielo y el aire no es vegan.
Pero eso decía que supuestamente
Tacho, porque tú te imaginas ya con todas las bacterias que hay en el agua y en el aire.
¿Verdad que sí? Ya.
Tacho, hay que andar con las máscaras.
Even with eyes, you can wait. Paloma, I'm so sorry. You know, I'm Paloma. The Spanish side. I'm the Puerto Rican side of the show. I'm sorry. You look so quiet there. Are you done taking selfies, sir?
I've got about 20 more to go.
20 more?
All
we
right.
We have to take one.
Well, Mimi, you want to say something before we go? This is another show that's about to end, so we got a couple of minutes, right, Mr. Montes? Yep. So.
That's right.
All right.
7 minutes.
7 minutes.
I just want to give a shout out to my family, to my husband, Robert, for his patience. Everything that I do, he supports me. I love you, baby. God bless you. Thank you to my family, my mom and dad, to my baby boy, Royal. You got this, baby boy. You're going to pass this assessment, and we're going to pass third grade. Everybody, keep an ear out for this Florida assessment testing. We're going to talk about this. It's a hot topic. Please keep us informed. Reach out to us. Buenas noches and good night.
Greg, my dear brother, Brett, is there anything else that you want to tell to us, man? Is this gonna? Can we have you like come to the show?
Be anytime, part of any right. place, anywhere. Right. Let's get together, Central Florida, and get on this Trump train, and just come together. Whether you're Democrat or Republican, it doesn't make a difference. We all have one focus, and that is to better ourselves.
That is good. That is good. So it's Orange County Trump Republicans Club and Facebook. Look for it and get there. Paloma, gracias, mi vida, por estar con nosotros. La semana que viene es otro día.
Gracias a ti, Jay.
Thank you very much. Al señor Miguel Montes, thank you very much for letting being our engineer. This Woo! Is... Yeah! Listen Woo! To me! Listen to me! Que estamos Listen creciendo... A brinco y a salto por la gloria de Dios. Dios lo da todo. Alice, Shammy, mi esposa, gracias. Te veo un ratito en mi corazón. ¡Mua! Listen to me en inglés, en español. El programa más pegado. Yes, we are. Chao.
Chao.